All right, welcome back everyone to another lecture on basic electronic concepts. Today we're going to cover resistors, which is one of the most basic electronic components that you're likely to encounter when you're working with electronics. This video is intended for anybody with an interest in electronics, and specifically for anybody who's interested in becoming an electronics technician in the Navy, or brushing up on their basic theory so that they can pass their rating exam. So what is a resistor? A resistor is a component that's made to have a specific resistance. And you'll see later on how this becomes very useful. So you can dictate what the voltage is at any given point, or you can lower the power. Or there's a lot of different things that you can do with a resistor. If you look over on the right side here, we have different types of resistors. Fixed carbon is probably one of the most common ones that you're going to run into. If you look over to the right of that chart, you can also see the different symbols that will represent those types of resistors on your schematics. You also have a fixed wire round. We'll talk a bit more about that in a moment. Adjustable wire round, a potentiometer, and a rheostat. Rheostats are typically used for a real high power type applications where you have to have kind of an adjustable resistance there. Anytime, if you look at the symbol there, how it has the little arrow pointing into the resistor, that usually signifies that there's some kind of an adjustable part to that resistor there, and you can change that value by adjusting some knob or something like that. Also, if you looked at the fixed wire round that has the tapped, those taps on there means that you could get a different voltage depending on at what point in the resistor you measured it from, and you'll understand that a little better later on down the road. All right, so one of the first things you're going to notice about the different resistors is there's a different size. Resistors have to be able to dissipate heat. As we had talked about in the last lecture, that anytime that you have electrons traveling over any kind of different surface or any kind of through any kind of material, some of that energy is going to be changed over into heat. So the higher that your power is at any given time, the bigger that your resistor is going to have to be in order for it to be able to give off enough heat. If the resistor isn't able to give off enough heat, then you're going to have a problem where either the value of the resistance is going to change due to that temperature changing, or worse, even the resistor itself might catch fire or fail, and then you have to do some troubleshooting to figure out what part failed. Which luckily for us, when a resistor fails, it's usually pretty obvious. You'll usually see a little burnt up mark on the board, and you'll know exactly what to go in and replace. So resistor values, there's two different ways that you might have to look at the resistor to figure out what the value is. The easier way, if you look on the left there, is sometimes just printed on the resistor itself, and that makes life very easy. You can just see, hey, that's a 10 ohm resistor right there. The other way is with the color bands, which adds a little extra step there, but it's really not that hard to figure out what those mean. So if you look at these color bands, it's on a standard carbon resistor there. You have the first digit, the second digit, the multiplier, the tolerance, and the quality band. Each of those is going to have a meaning to it. We have a chart here that explains what the meaning of each of them are. So the black one would be 0, brown is 1, red is 2, and so on according to that chart right there. And then also your tolerance percent, and then the reliability if it has one of those. So how do you remember that? The best way to do that is to create a mnemonic device, some kind of acronym or sentence that can help you remember that. The one that's given in the NEETS module is "Bad boys run over yellow gardenias behind victory garden walls." That's not the one that I learned. If you want to, ask a couple, more experienced people or something, you might find something that's more interesting, easier for you to remember. You might be able to just figure one out yourself. But basically what I do whenever I have to figure out what a resistor is, or at the beginning of a rating exam, is I'll go ahead and I'll, I'll write that down, BBROYGBVGW, and then, based on that, I'll put the 0, 1, 2, 3, and just so on that. And then that obviously stands for, bad would be black, and then boys is brown, run is red, O is orange, so on. You just write that down. So looking back at the chart, you can see how that would work out, and then just basically write that down on your scratch paper as soon as your test begins, or as soon as you have a need to know what a resistor's value is, and you'll be able to figure it out pretty easily with that. All right, so at this point, there's one more important thing to note, and that's the number of bands that a resistor may have. Sometimes that the tolerance and the quality bands may not be there. The quality band actually usually isn't there very often at all. The tolerance band may or may not be there. The first three bands, there may actually be three or four bands. In the case that there's four bands, what that means is that the first three would be the digits, and then the fourth one would be the multiplier. So whichever band is last, just make that your multiplier. And in the case that there was three digits, then it would just be, in the case of this one, since it's blue, red, red, if there was another red after that, it would be 622 times 100. Also with that, the tolerance band, like we were talking about, that tells you within how much of a percent of that that rate or that value that resistor has to be in order to pass the manufacturing test. So in the case of this one, it has a gold band, which means that it's within 5% tolerance, which means that it has to be within 5% of 6,200 ohms. So this resistor could really be 6,180 ohms, and it'd still be within that, and that'd be fine. But something just to check when you're checking out your resistors and using the multimeter on them to see if they're good or not. They may end up being out of tolerance because of some defect or something may have happened to it. All right, so that's pretty much it for resistors. It's a really simple topic here, probably one of the most simple components that you're going to run into really with electronics. So if you had any questions or any comments on that, please feel free to leave them there, and if you have any questions, I'll try and get them answered.